Good everyone, what is good? Welcome back to the channel with your truly, of course, Machiavelli, and today we're back with another Speedbolt. So today we are going to be doing, as the title says, yes, the title is correct, we are doing like some type of van build. I don't know. I really don't, but I have a confession to make. There's a reason why I didn't upload yesterday. One being my internet was being stupid. Well, for uploading, my download speeds were great, but my upload speeds were terrible, so it took me that one thing I uploaded yesterday, that one LP, it took me the whole night to upload that. Hopefully it's fixed today. If it's not fixed today, then most likely you're watching this on Sunday. If not, then hopefully you're watching this on Saturday. That would be good. But again, you never know with the Wi-Fi. But that was one of the reasons why I didn't upload. But another reason why is because at around, I don't know, 11 in the morning, I was on YouTube, and of course, recommendations. I got this recommendations for a van tour type of thing. And I always knew about people, you know, living in their vans. I wouldn't say, I just thought it was okay. I just thought it would be kind of weird, cramped up in a van, you know? But when I thought of vans, I didn't think of, you know those white RVs? I call them the rape vans because they look like rape vans, don't they? Like, when you see them on the street, you feel like somebody's being taken away. I call them the rape vans. I shouldn't, I know, but they always remind me of them. But anyways, moving on. You know those white, thick vans? I fully forgot that those could be changed too. And so when I went on it, When I looked at it, I was blown away by how they turned that, like, those pretty big white vans into, like, I don't say luxury, but this really compact, nice house. And you guys know, y'all know I love small spaces, and I love, and you know how much I love making a small space work. And so I just was obsessed with it. So for literally all yesterday, I watched every single tour / build you could think of when it comes to fans. Every single one. Think of any, I've watched it. Go on Google, look it up, I've watched it. I've watched so much to the point where I'm like, okay, how much does it cost to like buy a van? How much to like renovate it? Cause I'm totally about doing it. You guys know that I was about to do it. I was about like tiny houses. I love tiny houses. Now I'm kind of thinking that I have phases in my life. Even though I've been obsessed with tiny houses for like over 3 years now, this van thing seems, I don't know, it's like my new obsession slash it seems more realistic for me in that sense. With tiny houses, if I would have got one, I just wouldn't know where to put it. You know, I'd have to buy some chunk of land and do something like that. But if I bought a van and I lived in a van, then I could just park my van in my mom's garage or driveway and live in there, you know, have my privacy. It would just be cool too. And if we ever want to do a road trip, we can go in my van and then people could be in the back and doing stuff while, you know, we drive, or we have a place to sleep at night. That type of thing, you know, because whenever me and my mom and my brothers, me and my mom, my brother, and my dad, we go across the border to United States, we always like stay at this Walmart at night because we drive in the night because it's easier, and then we sleep at the Walmart for a few hours, and then we go shopping, then we drive back home. So it'd be really cool, you know, in the sense that, you know, instead of sleeping on an uncomfortable van, we can actually have this nice built up van. But anyways, no, that was just a thought in my head. I don't know. I really like them, and I've been obsessed with them. I've watched them last night. I've watched them this morning when I got up. It's all I've been thinking about. So yeah, I had to build one, and I tried to, as you can see, I tried looking for tires, but of course tires don't exist in this game because we don't have cars. Rip to that. We could be, who knows. So I had to improvise, and so I just like, you know what, F it. Whatever, I'll just do whatever I'll do whatever I have. And then I did that, and then I made the back windows, and I was gonna base this off of a photo that I saw, but then I was like, you know what, I'll just create my own, like, why not. I will say though that the front of the car, it's pretty bad. It's just two chairs in front of the windows because I didn't know how to like make an engine / like a steering wheel. Like, I couldn't find a steering wheel. I couldn't find anything in my game. So I was like, rip to it. I just put two chairs in front of it, and that's the driver's seat and the passenger seat. And then you have the build in the back. This is actually a family van, so there's a place for a toddler and two adults. Also, it could be like a single mom and their dad, or a single dad and their child. It's a single mom and their dad. Well, single mom, and it could be her single dad. It's up to you. But there is two beds, a toddler bed and a grown up bed. And yeah, I really like it. I haven't tested if I could actually get into it. This is mainly just for design. If you guys really want me to test out for it and all that type of stuff, I'll go ahead and do that. It might, I'm telling you, it might not work. It might, who knows, but there's a good chance it won't work. Everything's so cluttered together. If you guys are wondering where's the fridge, there is no fridge, because in these van houses the fridges are normally inside the cupboards or down below, and I couldn't really make a down below fridge, so I have to figure that out. If you want to put a fridge, there's a lot of room at the front of the vehicle. If you're actually going to play with this build, if you guys want to, let me know. You're gonna have to definitely, you're gonna have to most likely put the, you can also just, okay, this is the thing. Being completely honest, you don't need the front of the van. I guess the front of the van is to make it be a little more realistic, because of course you wouldn't have your kitchen at the front. But if you were gonna be honest and you're actually gonna live in here and try to make this functional, I'd recommend you just put the kitchen at the front of the van. And then where the kitchen is now, put a table or something, and then you have the two beds, and try to rearrange that. But of course, I'm trying to make this as realistic as possible, so I had to add a driver's spot, so there it is. So, there's no fridge, there's a lot of things that are missing. There's a tiny bathroom. Does it work? I highly doubt it, but I'll give it a check real quick. I can actually check right now while I'm doing this, because I do have my game open. I will say though, there's that. I hope you guys enjoyed the build. I tried. I really did. Hopefully I can improve, find some tires, and it can look way better. So, anyways guys, today's commentary of the day. So, guess what I got my brother to watch? After a million years of telling him to watch it, I got him to watch Gossip Girl, and he is obsessed like I was back in the day. And I was like, you know what, since he's watching it, I'll go ahead and rewatch Gossip Girl too. Like, why not? I love the girl. I love the show. You know, from what I remembered, I really did like Gossip Girl. So I was like, why not go ahead and try it out? So that's what I wanted to go ahead and do. And so I'm rewatching it again. I just finished. I'm actually two episodes away from finishing season one. But then I had to stop because I need to sit down and rant with you guys about my old self. And I feel like a lot of people were like me too. But a lot of us back in the days, we loved Blair. God help me. I loved Blair growing up. Wait, what the heck? Why are we here? Okay, go home, please. Let's go home. Anyways, yeah, I loved Blair. She was one of my favorite characters growing up. Now thinking back, I have zero clue why I like this girl. I'm sorry, but after watching all over again and realizing what she's done, and now that I'm more matured, I can see through herself. She's the biggest, excuse my language, B-ot in... Like, what? She's a spoiled brat. She's like, she literally has intent to her, like, all of her attentions, like, she'll step on anybody she has to get to the top. She doesn't care about her friends. Like, and the thing is, she's such a hypocrite too. Like, she'll say, oh my god, you're sleeping around with everybody, but yet she literally broke up with Nate. Like, and then an hour later she's having sex with Chuck. You know what? What? Like, and then she would, like, call out Serena for her, like, mucking around. She's like, oh, I can't do it. I can't be named that because I have to keep up my reputation. Then don't do it. Like, stop being a hypocrite. I'm sorry. I used to really like Blair, but now she annoys the hell out of me, honestly. And the thing is, I thought I was like, I can't be the only one who's like thinking that Blair is the actual meaning of the devil, you know? Like, if she was like a person in real life, I would go nowhere near her. She's just pure evil in that sense. Like, I kudos to her because she has a great mind and she's very conniving. And you know what? If she wants something, she goes for it. But the way she goes about it is so wrong and so manipulative and evil. She'll literally make you, like, what she did to Jenny too. That's straight out bullying. Like, what she did to Jenny. I know people, like, the funny thing is people don't like Jenny when she rebelled back. And you think after all she's been through trying to become friends with Blair and she rebelled back, you're like, oh my god, Jenny's, like, either for attention. Listen. don't mess with Jenny Humphries. I love Jenny Humphries. She's my second favorite character. My favorite character of all Gossip Girl is Nate. I know a lot of people don't like Dan, but after like growing up and watching again, I could really relate to Dan and where he's come from and his thought process. He's actually a pretty quirky dude, and he tells it how it is. Honestly, he's completely and utterly honest, and I can respect that so much. I can't. And that's one of the big reasons why I like that. I used to love Chuck, but then I realized Chuck is a true ass too. He's literally on the same level as Blair right now. He's a little bit lower, but he's still high up there. Like I said, it's so weird because I used to love Chuck. Like when I went to watching Gossip Girl this year, I was like, oh my god, I can't wait to watch Chuck. I love Blair. I can't wait to watch all of them then. I didn't like Serena that much. I still don't like Serena. She's just weird. I don't know. I have a love and hate relationship with Serena's character. But God, after watching, I'm like, how did I like Blair? How did I like her? She's so rude. Like, do you guys remember the episode where her dad comes and she literally trips the guy was being nothing but nice to her, but since she wasn't getting her way, she tried to rebel and she literally hurt the guy's leg. The guy did absolutely nothing to her. He was making an effort with her, and since she didn't like that and that her dad, oh my god, I'm sorry. She, I could go on for days how much she irks me. I just hate the way she treated Jenny. I'm sorry. That's pure bullying. I do not like. How did I not see that in the first season? I thought it was like, oh, it's fine. But no, she treated Jenny like ish. Like, she made Jenny do everything for her and gave her no respect for it, didn't really acknowledge her. And then, you know, and then she tried. And then another thing I hate too was a lot of people got, you know when, what's it called again? You remember when, in season one where, if you watched it now, the spoiler alert. But anyways, you remember in season one where Nate asked Jenny, like, what happened if he knows? And then you're like, honestly, people got mad at Jenny because Jenny actually told Nate that Blair had, Blair slept with, Chuck and then got back with, and then the next, like, few days slept with Nate. She faked her virginity. Yes, the girl faked her virginity. Like, get on her level of, like, Anyways, like, I felt, honestly, if you were in Nate's shoes, would you honestly feel bad? No, I'd say, like, honestly, if you were in Nate's shoes, like, wouldn't you want to know too? Wouldn't you feel bad? Not feel bad. Would you feel stupid that there's a rumor going around that your girlfriend like slept with another guy and you don't know? And then you go up to her and most likely she's going to tell you, like, she's going to lie to you. Knowing Blair, she would have lied and said, oh my god, it's not true and it's Chuck and all the other BS that she talks about. So wouldn't you like not trust it? And so for someone to come to you and tell you the truth, like, how is Jenny in the wrong? I went online to see if other people had the same opinion of her and everyone called her a B-I-T, like the B word, because she told. What do you, oh, I'm like, you guys are really out here getting mad at Jenny for telling Nate the truth that his girlfriend's been lying to him, making him feel like the bad person because he, you know, cheated with Serena a long time ago. Really? 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 And then she's like holding this over Serena's head and like, oh my god, I hate her. I can't describe how much I hate her character. I went from loving her to hating her just because how vile she is now. And she's just such a negative person in general. I don't know. She always puts herself above everybody. And the way she talks down to Dan too, like, oh my god, you're scum. And I need a shot to be next to you. Like, what? Bish, what? What? You need a shot to be next to another human being? All because they're just not as rich as you? All because they don't have the status as you? My god. I was shooketh. I'm like, really? She really just said that? Really? Really? I'm sorry. I had to rant. I was so pissed off. I'm like, and I go on these comments and everyone's praising her and saying she's funny and, you know, it's like, are you guys dumb? Like, I get it, you like her, but, like, are you guys, like, not seeing what she's done? She's done so much bad in this show. Like, so much. You guys are telling me you're just gonna turn a black. Like, really? Really now? Only person who I still rep to this day is Nate, because Nate's been a good guy throughout the whole series. He's been a good supportive friend to everybody. I haven't got to the part where I'm only past season one. So far he's been really nice. He's been good. Serena's been good, but a bit annoying. Dan's been decent, and all the other good stuff. I love Jenny still. I feel so bad for how much she went through, but yeah, I had to rant. I'm sorry. I just had to. I was my blood was fuming when I watched the things she was doing. But let me know down below if you have watched Gossip Girl, how was your opinion on Blair or all the cast members, and who's your, and a question of the day is, if you do watch, even if you don't watch Gossip Girl, who's your favorite character of any TV series? I'll tell you guys that one. Actually, no, cut that one. That's for tomorrow's episode. We'll do that tomorrow. Today is, what's your opinion on Gossip Girl if you watched it? If you haven't, then tell me about, you know, how would you describe, not do you describe, have you ever talked to a vile person before? Anyways, that's another question for another day. But yeah, anyways, today we're just going to Gossip Girl. So all people who watch Gossip Girls, let me know. What do you guys think of Blair? Because I hate her. I hate her. She's vile. She's a vile person. Oh my. Oh my. Oh no, I think I've lost my mind.